Hey, good morning everyone. Today we are going to discuss with how do we create a Maven project into SDS IDE. So in all the latest versions of SDS, you will have a built-in plugin for Maven. If anybody is facing issue like you're not able to create with the Maven project successfully, if you're not getting any, okay, while you're going to create with the Maven project, if it is not able to create successfully, what you need to do is go to help and then Eclipse marketplace. There are Maven plugins available for Eclipse. You need to install any one of the plugin. Actually, it is coming as a built-in for your updated latest versions of Eclipse. Still, if you are facing any issue, you just install with a plugin. So in the plugin, you need to search for, go to the find text box, search for MVN plugin or M2 plugin. So when you say M2, you will find, okay, there are the plugins, or else you search for MVN. So you will find likewise this Maven plugin. Okay, you can search for the available Maven plugins. The first one you can choose. Here you can observe that this latest Maven plugin for your applications, and then say install. It will take some time to install, so that it will ask you also to restart your SDS IDE. You can restart it. With this plugin, you must be able to create the Maven project successfully, right? In my machine, it is already there, so I am just canceling it. By you people, those who are facing issue to create a Maven project, you make it successfully. If it is asking for restarting your SDS ID, you restart it and then you start working with creating a Maven project. The next step is to create with your Maven project. I'll just take another instance of Eclipse, because it takes some time to create it. So I'm taking a new workspace so that we can work fast. So I'm taking the new workspace. So always when the number of applications are increased into your current workspace, you go for a new workspace. When you are starting with your case study, always preferably you need to start with a new workspace. And once this IDE, now we will be starting with the creating a Maven project. The main advantages we discussed in the Maven session, like Maven is a project management tool. It provides you a standard structure for your project to when it is created, and it provides you build management and then lifecycle management of the project, dependency management, version management, and reporting, okay, and adding of plugins required for your application execution process. There are lots many features are available with this Maven. So as we discussed before Maven, we had Ant tool, but Ant was providing only the build management. Maven is provided with lots many other features. So in the Maven project, when we create, there are two ways. Like, you can create a simple Maven project, everything you need to start from the scratch. And there is archetypes available for Maven. First, let me show you archetype. If you enable this, it is going to skip that a step called selection of archetype. Without skipping that step, let us create a Maven project. Here, whenever you create a Maven project, there are different types of archetypes are available. The type of application you are going to develop with, whether it is a web application, server-side application, whether it is a console application, based on that you need to choose the archetype. So as our sprint one application, we are going to do with the console application, means we are going to run with the main Java class. So we need an archetype called quick start. This is going to give you a Maven project for quick start archetype selection. So always group ID should be your, okay, organization name and your application name you can say. Let us say your application is Health Assist. So you can give, just I am giving as a sample HA, but you can give application specific. And then is your like you can also choose your batch name here, okay, for easy reference and while integrating your application from the team members, okay. And artifact ID should be purely your project name. So let us say yours is okay, Health Assist application, okay. You can say Health Assist app. And here is versioning is, whenever you do some changes with your code, you can maintain with the multiple versions for your project. Initially, it will be giving you 0.0.1 as a snapshot name. And then you just click on finish, a Maven project get created. See here, the structure of a Maven project is always in a standard way where we will get a SRC folder into which all the Java classes get created with. We can maintain here. And the test cases what we are going to create, we will be writing into SRC test Java package. And here is the important file for your Maven project is form.xml. So it is a project object model. So whenever you select this, sometimes you get like this. So you don't get any confusion, go to the form.xml tab so that you can see the project object model XML. This is the main configuration file for every Maven project, which will display with what is the group ID you are working with and what is the artifact ID and what type of file you are going to create once you are going to build your project. So if it is a web application, it is a var file. If it is a console application, it's a jar file. Likewise, the packaging type. And then here, name of the project will be again your project name. And the properties would be the additional properties you are going to use for every project, like what kind of source encoding you are using with when you are going to compile your Java files. Okay, the Maven built-in compiler will be looking into the coding style, encoding style, which is Maven specific. So this kind of configuration you will get default, you can keep it as it is. And further, the important thing is dependencies. When you create a template project, the basic dependency we need is, by default you will get a test cases. If you can observe into test package, you will get a default a test case written for you. This is what is we are getting by default with the Maven. So for that purpose, JUnit dependency will get a default. But if at all any changes are needed, like version wise or any other new platform is needed, then you can always add with your pom.xml. You can explicitly add the number of dependencies required. This is one way of creation, okay. And the other way is, like I am going to create with one more project, file, new, then select a Maven project. If you are not directly getting a Maven project here, go to other, you just select in this group, Maven is available, go here Maven and select the Maven project, and next. So here you just skip this step. If you are going to skip this archetype selection, it means you will be developing the application from the scratch. Again, I am giving com dot, okay. I will give ticket booking system, com dot, db dot, okay, cg dot, ticket booking, and artifact name is, and here packaging and the description and all you can just ignore. As of now, for the very first project, you can ignore. Right, you can say finish. Now one more Maven project get created with the same structure. You can observe. Now again you will get a SRC main Java where we are going to create with the Java classes. Resources, any configuration is needed, we do it in a resources folder. And test packages, we will get into this. And coming to pom.xml is your XML file. As we were not selecting with archetype selection, we will get a basic configuration needed. Further, you need to add all the required number of properties. This is another way of Maven project creation. So now every team, whoever is working on different groups, right, start creating your own Maven project and start writing your template code. As we discussed yesterday, okay, we have got a template code for let us say ticket booking system. I have some template code I will be showing you. Here you can see there is a template code available for which you need to start maintaining the package structure. So the package structure should be wherever you write your model classes, entities, model, okay, wherever you are writing your custom exceptions, give your exception as a package name, com.cg. your application name. Exception. All repositories means DOs should be in the DOs package, services should be in the service package. So this is the structure you need to maintain and start working on creating, okay, the template code for your application. Today we are going to work with the first repository layer. What exactly the functionality we are going to work with, you need to start working with. For every repository you have an interface, and then you must have an implementation class for that. Okay, we will be working on a repository. Once repository is completed, we'll be connecting with the service layer. First, all of you need to start with the repositories. So all the DAO classes you need to identify for your application and just make that templating application. And once this is done, we need to start working with the writing the unit test cases. So I'll be showing you a simple unit test case for this newly created project. So for example, we created a health assist application in which I create with the repository. So let us create a package com.cg.healthassist.repository. And in this repository, first let us say let me create with an interface. Medical store interface in which I have simply I am giving a get store rent. It's an abstract method. Now I am going to implement with the implementation class for this, means medical store repository implementation. If you wanted to make my class as a repository, you can also make it as repository, or you can make it as DAO. Right now I'm going to make an implementation class for this. Write a class medical store repository IMPL. Right, in this implementation class we are going to implement our rent method, okay, by writing a logic for. So as per the logic, you need to perform with all the business logic here, whether it is need to connect with any of the medical store table to calculate your rent based on the number of months or the duration. So you perform that logic, finally you will be returning the whatever value you are going to get it. Let us say I am just returning a static content here. This is what is my implementation. You need to implement as per your requirement statement. Once this is done, we need to write the test case for this. So all the test cases should reside into your test package. And to start working with this test cases, first of all we need the dependencies for JUnit. So how do we add the dependencies? So let us say I'll remove the older version. This is because it is 3.8.1. I'll take out this. Okay. And first I'll generate a test case for this. Right click on your class for which you need to write the test case. Okay. Say new other. We'll be creating with unit test case. So go to JUnit group, and within which JUnit test case, go to next. Okay. Select the test case name. By default it will give the naming convention, you follow the same, and you just select the type of the version you need. So I am selecting as we are supposed to do with the JUnit 5, you select the Jupyter version, which is JUnit 5, and all the lifecycle methods, right? So initially you start working on lifecycle methods as well. Setup teardown is needed to create your object. So let us make it setup and teardown for each test case method we are going to write with. Then next, what is the method we need to test? Select the method to be tested, method under test. Usually into your repository you may have multiple methods. I am showing only one single method, but it may have multiple methods. Select all the methods needs to be tested. Now it is going to add with the test case for you, and in this test case, okay, we need to write down the logic. For initially it is failed because we didn't write any logic. Further we need to add the required elements into the setup method. Okay, then we need to write down the logic for implementation. First we will create an object required to be tested. So in the setup method, first we will take medical store object, okay, and you create that object over here. In the setup method, always setup is needed to set up your test process, and in the teardown process you need to release that resources, so make it null. And then is in the test cases, okay, we need to write down the test case. How do we test it? First we will get the result called the rent. What we get is by calling our function ms dot, we need to call our test case function called get store rent. So we are getting the rent. So whatever rent it is returning, we need to test it. So assert equals of, right, the rent actually you are getting it, and the expected value. I am expecting, let us say, 5000. If the requirement is given like the rent should be 5000 for a given condition, we will be testing with that sample value. Here is a 5000 is called sample. Okay, this is sample data to test. Sample data, whereas the rent is called as the actual data which is coming from our application. So always the sample data should be tested against the actual data coming from. So this is how we will write the test cases. So for all the requirements into your application, first you will be developing all the repositories required, implementation for all the repositories. In each implementation you will have the multiple methods. You need to write the test cases. So test coverage should be above 70% so that the maximum number of logics what you have written here should be tested. Now as it is not added with the dependencies, means libraries, it is giving some errors, right? Now let us add the dependencies required. So I am going to show you a document where I will be displaying you the number of dependencies required. Add these dependencies into your, okay, pom.xml, so that it is going to pull the number of dependencies required. I have showed you like in Maven session, like what is a dependency management, how it will pull these number of dependencies into our local repository called M2 folder. So in C drive, if you go to users and the folder called M2, this is what is our local repository. Whenever certain libraries are not needed, while we are going to build our project, it is going to pull all these libraries and keep it in that folder which is called local repository. And when something is not available in the local repository, always your Maven will look for first local. If it is not available, it will connect it to the, okay, remote repository for your Maven central repository, which is a remote repository. From there it will pull the required library. So after you add the dependencies, always you need to build your Maven application. You need to update your project. Whenever you update, don't forget to enable this force update snapshots and releases, so that it is going to check with the dependencies required for your project, and it will get all the number of dependencies needed. So let us save this. Still it is building the workspace, it's not completed, it is taking some time. And here is system library, it is showing 1.5. always you need to look into the build path as well. Let me check my build path. In the build path, it is taking the default JREs as a 1.5. I'll go to library, I'll just change it, select, edit, Okay, you need to choose the J2SC version 1.8. You need to make it and then say finish, so that it should be J2SC 1.8, as we are working with 1.8 library. Now it is updated. Now here you can see the JRE system libraries J2SC 1.8. You just update your project now. So it takes some time to update with the library. Once this is done, okay, now you are going to test your, this is our test case. So this we need to test with. So this is a test case we are not going to use with, just let us remove that. We are going to use with our repository related test case. Now we have overcome that application, that Maven related issue, that is JUnit related issue. So now we are able to run it. So mainly in the setup method, we will create the number of dependent objects needs to be tested with. All the initialization process we do in the setup method. Resource releases should be done in a teardown method, and the test case method always we do the test cases. This part we have covered in JUnit. Once again, all of you refer to JUnit samples and video and start working on that. Now once this is done, when we don't have this logic to be tested, so initially we'll make our test case to be failed. So let us run with run as, okay, run configurations, you go with the JUnit. So select all the test cases into your current project, then say apply. You select the JUnit runner as a file, then say run. Now it is going to run your test cases and it will say that fail. Why? Because we don't have any implementation, directly we are running the fail method. Now once we have implemented our logic, just we will write the test case according to our application requirement. Actually, I have not created any logic here, just I am testing with the sample data, just to showcase your how do we implement with the unit test cases, right? Now we are going to run with run as. You are supposed to get the JUnit here itself. If you are not getting, don't get confusion, go to run configurations, go to JUnit, and in the JUnit, okay, you go to select the project name here and select the version of your JUnit library, select it and then say run. Now it is going to run the test case. The expected one is 5000 and the actual return value is 5000. So test case is matched. It means now you can proceed with the next requirement to continue with. Let us say I am checking with 6000. Let's say I am expecting 6000, but somehow your logic is returning 5000, let's say. Now I am going to test it again. So likewise, you must write the number of test cases for your application. Don't test with one sample data and like you cannot proceed with. You have to do negative test cases, positive test cases, n number of sample data you need to test with. That is the practice you have to make while you are writing the test cases and running the test cases. Hope you are all clear with how do we create a Maven project, and along with adding the dependencies for JUnit 5 and writing the test cases and the structure of the project you have to maintain with.